This guy, you've heard of him, for many reasons perhaps, but for this video, we're gonna look at his contributions to physics, or in other words, why he won the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1967. Now, according to the Nobel Committee, Feynman and his colleagues won the award because for their fundamental work in quantum electrodynamics with deep plowing consequences for the physics of elementary particles. For the uninitiated, quantum electrodynamics is the unholy child born out of wedlock between quantum mechanics and relativity, specifically for electrons and photons, and this was Feynman's contribution. If you've been around the pop physics block, you know this to be Feynman diagrams. Diagrams that famously simplify a lot of complicated equations that describes two electrons bumping into each other. It's not that hard to understand what this diagram means. There's a vertical time axis and a horizontal space or position axis. The lines represent the electrons and the arrows denote how the electron is moving. The wiggly lines represent the particle that carries the electric force that repels the two electrons. The arrows are interesting because if they point in the same direction as time, then it is the particle. But if it's pointing in the opposite direction, then it is the antiparticle? Don't ask why. The simplicity of Feynman diagrams is what makes it really useful. This equation becomes this diagram. Pretty neat, huh? Speaking of neat, there's a really quick and dirty way to look at graphs and animate them, so to speak. Say you've got a graph describing the motion of a ball being thrown up. You have distance from the ground on the y-axis and time on the x-axis. All you have to do is make a rectangular slit, orient it like so, and move it along the time axis. And voila, you see this red blob that represents the ball moving up and down. Except it's not just moving up and down, this is scientifically accurate.
Take that, Nolan!
Similarly, in our Feynman diagram, the time axis is also upward, so you have to move it along the time axis. Then you get this, two electrons moving towards each other and one electron tells the other electron to move away. Amazing, right? No, because this is wrong. It's wrong for a lot of reasons, and explaining these reasons require explaining quantum electrodynamics, which I'm not sufficiently qualified to do. So I'll explain the one big reason why it's wrong. For starters, while it looks like one, a Feynman diagram is not a graph. Because I could take this diagram, stretch these lines, and none of the underlying math would change. But the animation is completely different. The truth is, even if your quick and dirty animation does not agree, all of these diagrams are identical. This is because the actual lines are not the important part of a Feynman diagram. Sure, they are, for bookkeeping reasons. All that matters, mathematically at least, is how many of what kind of lines go into and come out of each vertex. But the truth is, a Feynman diagram is actually a graph, and when I say graph, I mean one that looks like this. You've probably heard of Euler's Königsberg bridges, the puzzle where you have a bunch of islands with bridges connecting them, and you need to walk through all the bridges such that you would cross each bridge only once. You can simplify the problem by removing all the unnecessary details and distilling it to the most important information. Here, the bridges can be straight, bendy, and the vertices themselves can be wherever, but it doesn't really affect the final answer, because the information regarding the vertices are the only things that matter. Same thing over here. However, the idea of using graphs to simplify or keep track of the math is not a new idea in physics. If you've done physics in high school, then you've drawn or at least seen circuit diagrams. Take this circuit for example. You could draw it this way, or this way, or this way. It doesn't matter. All the values that you care about, potential difference, current, resistances, they remain unchanged despite how you prefer to represent the real circuit. That's because this is only notationally showing you all the complicated physics hiding behind these junctions and resistors and whatnot. Think about it. If current is electrons moving through the wires, it isn't, and these wires suddenly bend, then imagine all kinds of complicated bumping and whatnot that must happen and you need to care about. Well, you don't have to, because most of the time, for the values that you care about, how you bend the wire doesn't really matter. Feynman diagrams aren't some direct representation of the universe, like your graph of a ball being thrown. It's like a circuit diagram, except instead of electrons moving in wires, you have electrons bumping against each other. Kind of. Not really. It's complicated. But these diagrams were extremely important because while it did not represent nature, at least not in the way we expect diagrams to, they reveal something deeper. But that is a video for another day. Of course, you wouldn't know when this video is coming out, not because of some quantum anomalies, but because my upload schedule is crazy. So if you want to know more, why not subscribe to this channel and hit the bell button, because those things totally work. Also, if you like this video, don't forget to press the thumbs up button, and don't forget to share this video to your friends who are coked up on reading pop science books about particle physics. Blah! Anyway, thanks for watching.